Welcome to 3D Musketeers. My name is Grant, and you're making awesome. You asked for it, we got it. This is our best budget FDM 3D printers for your budget setup. Coming at you right after the intro. We are so glad to have you here at the 3D Musketeers YouTube channel. Don't forget, if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button if you want to see more videos about affordable 3D printers and why some of them are great and some of them aren't. There are two versions of this video. You are currently watching the long format version. So if you want to get it nice and quick and get on with your day, there'll be a link in the description for you as well. And while you're down there, don't forget to leave us a comment and click that like button, so that we know that you want to see more content like this. But these are all printers under $1,000 that we at 3D Musketeers recommend. Now, before we get too far into it, I want to let you all know that we do not make money by selling 3D printers. Yes, the links are affiliate links, so we do make just a little hair here and there, but we are not motivated to sell you an expensive 3D printer. We recognize that not everybody can afford an expensive 3D printer because, well, expensive 3D printers are, well, they're expensive. And you're not always getting good value for the money spent. So this is really all about value. Because at the end of the day, if you can spend $200 and get something that works, or you can spend $400 and get something that works considerably better, it might be worth saving that money. So we look at our variations here, and unfortunately, there are only two sources for where these printers come from. We've got China and the Czech Republic. Unfortunately, from what we could find, there are not a lot of great American-made 3D printers under $1,000 that aren't going to really make you do a ton of work. And so that's really a feature here, is the least amount of effort needed. Let's start at the bottom of the list, and this one's a bit difficult. It's the Elegoo Neptune 2 3D printer. Its build volume is 220 by 220 by 250, and that's roughly 8.5 by 8.5 by 10 inches. But this is made in China by Elegoo. They're really well known for their SLA and resin 3D printers. There'll be more of them coming shortly. It does have some features that we like to see in these types of machines. However, its biggest value is its price point at $160. It's got a runout sensor. It's got power loss detection. It unfortunately does not have auto bed leveling. But honestly, at $160, are you really expecting it? Because I'm not. Do understand this printer is incredibly difficult to find. And if you want to know how we are able to find printers that are incredibly difficult to find, leave us a comment below, because I will teach you how to find these kinds of things. And it's how we've been able to get some of the printers on this list that are also very, very difficult to come by. The next two machines on our list are both from Creality, and they are both of the Ender 3 series, the Ender 3 Pro and the Ender 3 V2. They are both the exact same build volume as the Neptune 2 at 220 by 220 by 250. They are Bowden-style extruders like the Neptune 2, and they both have power loss detection. They do not, that we can tell, have run-out sensors. The Ender 3 Pro is at $240, and the Ender 3 V2 is at $289. They are both prime shipped on Amazon, similar to the Neptune 2, so you get them very quickly when you can find them. The Ender 3 came out a few years ago and kind of took the industry by storm, right? You're looking at machines that are incredibly affordable, like $200-ish, $250 for a 3D printer that I can get on Amazon to my door like that. Pretty awesome. They're not bad machines, but the lack of auto bed leveling does make it a bit of a pain in the butt when you are looking at running them pretty hardcore. Because otherwise you have to use a sheet of paper and level out the nozzle. basically it's old tech. They do have upgrade kits that are community-based, like easy ABL, you can add BL touches, and other things. And so if you are looking at getting an affordable 3D printer that is under $300, and you want auto bed leveling, let us know as well in the comments, because we can do a whole video where we buy one of these cheap 3D printers and show you how to install auto bed leveling on it, because, well, that's a thing. And we highly recommend that you get printers with auto bed leveling. The build volume is nice on these because the next machine on our list, you're sacrificing a bit of build volume in exchange for build quality. Coming out of the Czech Republic, we've got the Prusa Research Mini Plus. And these machines are awesome. We have four of them here at 3D Musketeers, and they are little tiny workhorses. At 180 by 180 by 180, or 7 inches cubed, they're, well, pretty awesome. They've got a $400 base price point, but for $20 extra, you can add a filament runout sensor. Just spend the money. It's worth it. Seriously. The first time you lose a print because you forgot to change your filament over, you're gonna wish you had it. And it's never about the cost of the filament, because filament's not very expensive generally. It's the cost of the time that you now have to spend doing the print over again. Nobody wants to go through that. It does have auto bed leveling using the brand new Super Pinda, which enables incredibly accurate, high detailed bed leveling for even a printer this small. It is Bowden, which we're not a huge fan of. We do prefer direct drive printers here at 3D Musketeers because they just work better overall. But it is coming out of Prusa, so you know it's going to be a good machine. It does not currently have power loss detection, but we are told that it is coming in a future firmware release. So when it does come, we're going to try it. We're going to take one of our minis and rip the power out of it and see what happens. But at $399 or $419, that's a really tough bargain. It is not from Amazon. It comes straight from shop.prusa3d.com. And well, there are two options. You've got your $349 total kit, or you've got the mostly assembled, which is the $399. We don't see a valid reason to not spend that extra $50 and get it mostly assembled. And if you're wondering what that whole process looks like, there's links in the description to where myself and the Better Three Quarters raced to assemble a mostly assembled Prusa Mini Plus live so that you guys can see what it's actually like when you pit someone who has not a ton of experience up against someone, well, who does. And the race was a lot closer than most of you might expect. They're great printers. You can 3D print handles for them as well, so you can just kind of pick it up and go. And because it's got auto bed leveling, you can literally just pick it up, slap the stupid thing on a table, click print, and it's going to work 99 times out of 100. And you know what? That's pretty good. Honestly, I would say 999 times out of 1,000. We have such good rates on our Prusa printers. The next machine, more stuff out of Creality because, well, Creality kind of owns this affordable market for 3D printers right now. It is the Ender 5. And the Ender 5 is an interesting machine. It's kind of a Core XY setup. So instead of a bed slinger where the bed itself actually moves back and forth and the gantry, which holds the extruder, moves up and down, the Ender 5, the bed just moves down. Then there's a gantry system up here that doesn't move up or down. So you end up with a machine that's a little bit more stable that you can run faster. Do note that the Ender machines and most of these Creality machines are not all metal hot ends, and that means they're limited to going above 240, 250 degrees centigrade, while the Prusa machines on this list are all metal and capable of doing almost 300 degrees centigrade. So you're able to print a wider variety of materials. That machine has a build volume of 220 by 220 by 300, so a little bit bigger than your Ender 3s and your Neptune 2, but it's a little bit more expensive at $399 US dollars. But again, Amazon Prime shipped. It does require a couple of essential quality of life printed upgrades, but it is far superior to the Ender 3, and we do believe that the Ender line of machines, quite frankly, basically every printer out of Creality, requires some quality of life upgrades for it to be functional in an environment like this, where you're running really hard all the time. If you're just doing it as a hobbyist, you can probably get away with not all that many upgrades to it. It is a Bowden drive, that is to be expected. It does not have an all-metal hot end. It does have power loss detection, however, no automatic bed leveling or filament runout detection. And again, Creality machines are made in China, so, you know, that's between you and yours, whether you want to support them. We don't mind Creality, but we are at a point here at 3D Musketeers where we are willing to spend money on quality. And even though the Prusa Mini is affordable, it is higher quality, in my personal opinion, in Grant's personal opinion, than a Ender or even the Ender 5. But if you're looking for size, it's tough to beat the CR10 V3 from Creality. It is 300 by 300 by 400 millimeters, or 12 by 12 by 16 inches. To give you an idea, that's a big damn bed slinger. So this is where the bed moves back and forth, okay? And at $530, you've got a bit of an issue here, because a plate that big is almost guaranteed not to be flat. These machines do not have automatic bed leveling. We would say if you're getting a CR10 or a larger machine like this, you need to have automatic bed leveling, because it is a quality of life feature that will keep you from strangling your printer and potentially threatening to strangle your loved ones. Because, you know, we want to avoid that here at the 3D Musketeers YouTube channel. But it's not a bad machine. It's huge, right? And so if you're looking to print something really big and you don't want to glue it together and learn how to finish parts, by the way, if you're looking to learn how to finish parts, hit that subscribe button, because we're going to have videos coming at you on how to finish parts. And those are going to be a little bit weird because we can't do those inside. But it is a big printer. It is direct drive as well, which is nice from a Creality machine. But again, not an all-metal hot end. It's just something you got to think about. But at $529, it's got a brace on it, which helps it be a little bit more sturdy. It's not bad. I mean, it's not. If we were in the market for a big bed slinger 3D printer, I would think the CR10 V3 would be on that short list. Quite frankly, there aren't that many in that size bracket at that price point. However, our big printers are all Core XY or non-bed slinger style 3D printers. And if you're interested in learning what Core XY means, what bed slinger means other than Cartesian, or what Cartesian means, let us know again in the comments. I know I'm asking for a lot of comments, but we need your help, right? This is a whole new world for us. We want to produce content that you all want to listen to and watch. So help us out. Help me out. Help me help you. Kind of deal. Our favorite printer, which of course happens to be the most expensive, comes out of the Czech Republic once again, ladies and gentlemen, the Prusa i3 MK3S Plus. Because apparently Joseph Prusa wants to take his naming scheme from Apple. I don't know. The machine is a little bit smaller than your Ender machines. It is 250 by 210 by 210. There are actually four of them behind me. The backdrop that you see in all of our videos are Prusa i3 MK3Ss. We don't have the Plus variant. There's not a huge difference to them, and these are all old enough to not be the Plus variant. They've got automatic bed leveling. They've got a filament runout sensor. They've got power loss detection. They're freaking direct drive. They're all metal hot ends. And this is one of the times where we actually recommend the kit. It is $749, and with their shipping, it comes in under the $800 price point. And that's a big deal, because in the United States, if you go over $800, you have to pay import duties and taxes. And that can add a little bit on there. If you're in Canada, you're paying it anyways. I'm sorry, I can't help you. In the UK, there's VAT, and Prusa has a whole thing about VAT. You know, so you're not getting surprised with any bills or anything like that. But here's the deal. They're not cheap, right? It's $800. Basically, by the time you get it, it's $800. And it is a kit. And when I mean a kit, I mean a kit. Like, full-on assembly instructions, full-color pages here, so you can easily see what's going on. And to give you an idea of how thorough the instructions are for an i3 MK3S Plus, and this is an old version for those of you that are looking at buying a machine. This is version 3.12. I think they're in version 4 now. But the instructions are so good. If you take a look, in the box of one of these kits is a bag of Haribo gummy bears. And they tell you throughout the process when and how many gummy bears to eat, because this is truly like a 10 to 12 hour process. But the reason we're going to recommend that you get the kit is what happens when your printer has a problem. Not if. The answer is when, not if. That's the thing with 3D printing. Similar to sewing or using a Cricut, really a Brother or a Silhouette, because, you know, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, just search Cricut on our YouTube channel. You'll see what I mean. But using those machines, they're not perfect. And 3D printers have only been around since the mid-80s, 1984 to be exact, is when Chuck Hull invented 3D printing. So it's kind of a new thing, if you will. But these Prusas, I kid you not, are very much the Ron Popeil of 3D printers. Set it and... if you didn't say forget it, well, I don't know. Maybe Ron Popeil has just sat in my mind for many years because I used to watch his infomercials as a kid. Don't judge me. But anyways, you can set it and forget it. They're very, once you get them dialed in, you can walk away from them. If a 10 to 12 hour build is very daunting for you and you don't think it's within your abilities, I would challenge you and say that it is. To give you an idea, my girlfriend, Amber, was able to build one of these printers in about 11 hours. And the printer actually tells you how close you got to perfect. She was 0.01 degrees. The best I've ever done was 6.5 hours. And I think that printer was 0.05 degrees out of square, which isn't bad. It's just not great. The printer can actually adjust for that all in its setup procedures. And it's actually pretty easy. But if you're looking to say, you know what, I just want to buy it and I want it to work, they're $1,000 US plus shipping with a 3 to 4 week lead time on either the kit or the assembled version. If it's not overtly clear, my pick is Prusa, and my pick is always going to be Prusa on the under $1,000 price point for 3D printers. And yes, there are lots of other machines in this price point. However, we're just not certain that they really fit what we are looking for, because ultimately a lot of you out there are looking to step up your game and get into this 3D world. And to do that, we want to help you be confident when you get in there. So yeah, that's our list for affordable FDM 3D printers. If you are wondering, well, what about the high detail resin? Don't worry, that video is coming at you shortly. And if it's already here, well, there should be a card popping up right over here, over here. I don't know which side of YouTube it comes on, so somewhere. We hope you all enjoyed this video. Let us know in the comments what you thought of it. Are you going to get a 3D printer? And if so, which one? If it's not on the list, put it down there and I will comment and we can walk through some of the pros and cons of it. And if we really like it, maybe we'll get one for ourselves. Be kind of cool. Thank you again so much for watching. Don't forget to click that subscribe button, ring that bell. That way you can get notified when we produce more content. My name is Grant. This is 3D Musketeers. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to call your loved ones. Keep making awesome and have a wonderful day.